I've been working on this painting, which is going to take quite a while, because all these flowers that, they take a long time to do. Anyway, I figured tonight, since, as you could probably hear, a nice rainy evening, I would paint some flowers. These are done with, I believe this is a combination of cadmium red, Windsor violet, and I believe a touch of titanium white. The darker sections. Shadow on the flowers is done basically by adding a bit more of the the Windsor violet and a bit of burnt umber. So as you can tell, they're not all exactly the same shade. That just creates a bit more variety. So we basically just don't mix up all the paint you think you're going to need at the start. That way, you know, you're not going to get exactly the same color when you remix it. I should really think about doing some of these a bit darker back in the shadows. I can deal with that. Start dealing with that while I'm working on them now, I guess. So these are supposed to go up all the way up to here. You can probably make out faint pencil drawing for the rest. This guy's head poking up over this giant pile of flowers. So I'm using a couple different brushes. This is a number 2 round. And say one round and a 3-0. Just depends on how much detail I want to get. And the other two over here are, I think, both zeros. And that's a brush I use for something else. And a few older brushes that I use for stuff where, you know, if you don't wash the brush immediately, it can get messed up. Acrylic, for example. And, you know, if I have a brush that's a little nasty already, then I'll just do that instead. Put my wash water over here, so I'm not reaching across the entire thing. I haven't been doing a whole lot of paintings that involve flowers, but I've done a few, and I find them interesting. I don't know, I started using my SX70 Polaroid a bit more, and I found myself photographing mostly plants, really as close up as you can with that, which is not super close up, but it's close enough. And then I just started seeing them, you know, very slowly make their way into some of my paintings as well. I don't know, they're just sort of colorful and interesting. These are not any specific flowers, though. Could easily be interpreted as cherry blossoms, which are apparently in pink season at the moment, and I think it's Washington. I don't know about the ones in Japan, if it's the same time of year. constantly find myself taking on these pieces where I have to paint similar things over and over. And I always like the results, but it gets repetitive after a while to do it. And then I always tell myself, oh, I'm not going to do that for a while. And then I do. Because, of course. So while I wait for that last batch of flowers to dry a bit more, I'm going to take some of the red that I've been using and add a bit more burnt umber to it. I think it needs a bit more purple as well. Yeah, I was kind of wondering what I would do to fill in the space between, because I didn't really just want to leave it this sort of blue-green. It's like, well, I need to put in some leaves and stems, but I can also just sort of make it a little darker. But I can also add in some flowers that are more in shade. To give it a bit more depth, hopefully. another thing I'm going to come back in and do, and I've started doing down here, is using a much lighter pink to do some highlights. Because I use titanium gouache, titanium white gouache, that's a little easier to do than it would be if I just used watercolor, because it's much more opaque. Looks like I need to mix up a bit more. That's way too red. That might be about right. Yeah. A lot of the ways that I... I use watercolor are not really the way you're supposed to do it. You know, do what works. Which I mostly found out by trial and error. Still trying to learn a few actual more traditional techniques here and there. Especially if there's something I'm trying to do and I can't figure it out. But overall, I mostly just taught myself. I'd done other painting with oil, acrylics, and I'd actually had a few classes. Never taken a watercolor class. Kind of like to, but you know, I'll get around to it or I won't. Let's say that's a pretty good amount of progress for half an hour. So, I'm gonna do something else so my brain doesn't explode from painting flowers over and over and over. I certainly hope you've enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.